Welcome to the Monmouth County Board of Elections training video. This training video will provide instructions on operating the ABC Advantage voting machine. On election day, all poll workers will be expected to correctly operate this machine. You will be responsible for ensuring fair and reliable voting to the citizens of Monmouth County. The ABC Advantage machine has both a front and a back side. The machine itself weighs about 265 pounds. It has a power cord that extends up to 16 feet. In a polling location where multiple machines will be placed, it is possible to have one machine plugged into another machine and the final machine plugged into a wall outlet. When the machine is plugged in, the indicator light on the side will be fully illuminated. One of the first steps is to lock the machine in place. Press down on the brake with your foot. This locks it in place. To unlock the wheel, simply push up on the brake with your foot and release the machine from its locked position. Each and every machine has a unique identifier, also known as the serial number. It is affixed to both sides of the machine. There are two keys you will receive on election day. These keys play an important role in the functionality of the ABC Advantage voting machine. The set of keys come with an ID tag. Make sure the ID tag number matches the serial number on the side of the machine. Each key has a special purpose. The yellow key opens both the front and back panel of the machine. The silver key opens and closes the polls. More about this in a moment. Now, it's time to raise the front side of the machine. Pull on the maroon latch release to raise the front up. This is how the machine will look with the front raised. To adjust the angle, simply pull back again on the latch release. Unlock the front panels by using the yellow key. Remember that the yellow key opens both the front and back panels of the ABC Advantage machine. The top privacy panel rests on the two side panels. Make sure that rests correctly on the side panels. Now it's time to open the back panel. Again, use the yellow key to open the back panel. When you open the back panel, you will find specialized equipment. The ABC Advantage machine contains the operator panel, printer, audio assistance pack, power on-off switch, open-close poll key switch, and a cartridge. Remove the audio assistance device as well as the emergency ballot at the open of the polls. Let's begin. First, remove the operator panel and place it in its specialized slot on top. On election day, you will activate each voter using this operator panel. The operator panel looks at the operation of the machine, its hardware and software components. During a primary election, the operator panel will have a special slip indicating the Republican and Democratic parties. The voter will provide a voting authority. It is the responsibility of the board worker to select the appropriate party and then activate the voter. More on activating a voter in a moment. Once the operator panel is removed, you will see two knobs and a blue button. These are hidden by the operator panel until it's removed. The first knob will read power on/off. The second is open/close poll key switch. And the blue button is print more. Now, it's time to power up the machine. To turn on the power, simply turn the power on-off knob to the on position. One quarter turn to the left. The operator panel will take a minute to load up. The operator panel will indicate that the machine is on and ready for the polls to be switched on. The silver key will open the polls. Take the silver key and insert it into the open-close poll switch. Turn the key one quarter turn to the open position. That's one quarter turn to the open position. Once the polls are turned on, the printer will begin to print a zero-proof report. This report contains important information. The zero-proof report contains the information about the machine at the beginning of the election day. It contains the serial number of the machine, a protective counter number, and the public counter number. The protective counter number records all the votes that have ever been cast on this machine. The public counter number must read zero. The zero-proof report also contains the election district location number and all of the candidates on the ballot. There should be zeros corresponding to the candidates since no one has voted on the machine yet. Please note, there is a paragraph toward the end of the printout. The board members are responsible, indicating and documenting the date by filling in the blanks within this paragraph. Underneath the paragraph, there are lines for each board member to sign. The most important part of the zero-proof report is at the very bottom. That's the very bottom of the printout. There is an automatic timestamp marking the time at which the board members opened up the polls. Always make sure to arrive at the polls at the designated time. The curtain storage tube is located underneath the back control panel. To remove the top of the curtain storage tube, we recommend that you use an eraser tip of a pencil to push in the button. Once removed, you may pull out the privacy curtain and unravel it. Be sure to put the cover back on so that no one will trip or step on it. Unravel the privacy curtain. Then, place the privacy curtain rods into the holders. Always make sure the back panel is locked up when you're finished opening up the machine. Voters may have questions about the new machine. In this section, you'll learn just how simple and easy the ABC Advantage machine is to vote on. The full-face ballot with easy-to-read instructions helps citizens make selections by pressing the touchscreen boxes next to the candidates' names. A write-in touchpad makes write-ins easy to use. For visually impaired voters, there's also the audio-assisted device equipped with headphones. Activate each voter by clicking on the green Activate button on the operator panel. Press the black raised square on the ballot next to the candidate's name to select the candidate. A green X will appear next to the box, indicating your selection. Now, continue to make your selections by pressing the raised buttons. To deselect a candidate, simply click on the button again, and the X will disappear. As you make your choices, the green X light on the header's indicator will extinguish from the selected position as seen here. If you choose to deselect your choice, the green X in the main position box will relight. For a write-in vote, click in the appropriate button where it indicates a write-in. When you click in the write-in box, a green blinking X will appear next to the write-in box. This indicates that the write-in is ready. Then, proceed to the write-end panel and begin to type in your selected write-in candidate. There's a space and a backspace arrow. The space arrow allows you to enter a space. Then continue to type in the write-in's last name. Before hitting enter, make sure that the name that you entered is correct. If not, use the backspace arrow to correct the name. Should there be punctuation for dots, dashes, apostrophes, or commas, you will use the yellow buttons. That's the yellow buttons. To complete the write-in, click the Enter button, locking in your choice. Once this action is done, you cannot undo this action again Remember, you cannot deselect a write-in vote once it is completed. When finished with this process, press the lit cast vote button and you'll hear a tone, and the light will automatically extinguish, indicating your vote has been recorded. Advise voters with small children entering the booth to have children situated on their left side so that they are not tempted to press the cast vote button on the lower right side prior to the adult completing their vote. Adjust the height of the machine by pulling on the maroon latch release handle. Place the black wire into the controller. Place the controller and headset into the hands of the voter. The controller buttons are each marked in Braille and in English, and are designed with a different color and shape for each button to accommodate a voter who may be fully or partially impaired. The headset allows the voter to listen to a verbal interpretation of the ballot using the volume and speed control buttons according to their ability in complete privacy. The voter may choose to step inside the booth or remain outside the booth, as no visual indication of how a voter is voting is displayed anywhere. To begin, the operator must press the yellow test button. Observe the message. Press the yellow test button once again. Observe the message. Activate the green button to start loading audio. Audio mode will appear on the panel. Press the green activate button again. A sound will indicate the machine is ready for the voter. You can review this step, resetting the operator panel for the next voter, and further instructions on audio voting in detail in your instruction booklet. Retrieve keys from their envelope and cross-reference key tag number with the machine number. Using the yellow key, open the rear door by turning 1/4 turn and remove the key. Insert the silver key into the polls open close switch and turn 1/4 turn to closed position. You will hear a tone and in a few seconds the results report containing the official election results will begin printing. While this is printing, return to the front of the machine. Remove the privacy curtain. Roll it up and bring it to the storage tube at the rear of the machine. Remove the end cap. Place the curtain inside and remember to replace the storage cap cover. Use the yellow key to lock the privacy panel doors at the front of the machine. Remove the key. Pull forward to bring tube back down into its original position. If you accidentally drop it, its safety mechanism will prevent it from falling. Just pull the latch again until it is in the closed position. By now, all copies of the results report have finished printing. Remove the reports. You will see the tallied results along with the date and time the polls were closed and all other pertinent information. The board member must complete the elections officer's portion, and all four must sign the official election results report. After all reports have been printed and verified, the operator panel should read, "Polls closed." Now it's okay to turn the red power knob to the off position. Remove the results cartridge from the rear of the machine by pressing down on the button at the top of the cartridge. Next, pull the cartridge out. Place the final result reports, the zero proof report, and the cartridge into the bag provided by the Board of Elections. Post one copy for public viewing. Return the operator panel, audio kit, and emergency ballot box to their designated storage areas inside the rear of the machine. Remember to return the keys in their envelope into the kit. The used voting authorities on the string should be placed inside the canvas bag with the poll books. Next, unlock the rear wheels and return the machine to the location it was in when you arrived. Then, replace the cover. Finally, your day is over, and you can bring the official election results to the Municipal Kirk. Thank you for watching this training video. Please refer to your instructional book for more information. Additional questions may be answered by the Monmouth County Board of Elections.